Hi everybody and welcome to another awesome tutorial. This is Dawn and I am the brain behind nerdygirlcreative.com, which is a site where you can create, learn, and share graphic design ideas and projects, as well as get awesome design assets and a lot of freebies. This week we're going to be working on this beautiful, lovely, feminine logo and also this rad, awesome, grungy texture logo. I didn't want to leave the guys out this week, so I'm going to go ahead and make both. We're going to make this sort of more masculine version and then the nice cutesy pretty version over here. All right, so we're working in Illustrator this week. I'm going to go ahead and rubber band this one, kind of move it out of the way just so we can work in our document. My document's about 400 by 400 pixels, and the first thing that we're going to do is create circles. So I do not want to fill, but I do want to stroke. So I'm going to go ahead and here and hit swap. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit L on my keyboard, which is the ellipse tool. So I'm going to go ahead and drag out my first circle. All right. And I don't want a uniform stroke here. So I'm going to go ahead and click this varying width one here. So it kind of, as you can see, creates a wider stroke and then a thinner stroke and then comes back out to it. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. I'm going to Control or Command C, and then I'm going to Command or Control F, which is going to paste it directly on the front, F for front. So, all right. And then I'm going to hold Shift and kind of drag this circle out here. All right. And then I'm going to go ahead and Command F again to paste another one. I'm going to drag this one out, but I'm also going to kind of like shift this one off to the side a little bit just so that they're not all uniform together. Just kind of move them around a bit until you get the kind of shape that you like. And I'm going to make this one bigger. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and group them together. In order to put the foil texture on here, which everything that we're going to be working with today is absolutely free. The fonts here, they're free. They're free for commercial use. You can use them as many times in any kind of project that you want, whether you're going to sell it or not. And this foil texture I actually created and I'm going to give to everybody here for free because that's what I like to do. I like to give things away. I'm going to leave a link in the description below where you can grab all of the assets that we're going to be using today. So in order to put the clipping mask over our circles here, I am going to go ahead and come up here and go up to Object. I need to expand the appearance, which is going to give us all these points. And then I need to create a compound path, which is going to, it's also Command or Control 8. Go ahead and do that. And then I'm going to bring in my gold foil texture. So as you can see, it's kind of in a pack. I've been working on making quite a few of these, but the free one I'm going to be giving away is the gold. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and place it. As you can see, it's quite large because I am making this for another pack where, you know, size matters. So, all right. Then I'm going to go to come on and place it over here. And when creating clipping masks in Illustrator, the object that you want to, I guess, have the mask is going to be in the back. So it's kind of the opposite from Photoshop. As to where when you make a clipping mask, you want it in front or on top of it. But this one, you want it in the back. So you're going to go to Arrange and send the back. Then we're going to rubber band both. I'm going to Command 7, which is going to make the clipping mask. So you can also find it up here in Object. Down here, Object Clipping Mask. All right, so now we have our gold on our nice pretty circles here. And the next thing we're going to do is create all these little speckles here. This is actually a really interesting and fun tool to use for creating objects that you want along a circular path and you want them spaced evenly. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and create another circle. Whether it has a stroke or a fill, it doesn't really matter. So I'm just going to leave it at what it was sitting at. I'm going to go ahead and kind of shift it here. we're going to move in. And how I move my artboard is holding shift and then clicking my mouse and just moving my artboard around. But all right, so for these tiny little speckles, I do not want to stroke, but I do want to fill. So I'm going to go ahead and hit L again. And I'm going to create these tiny little varied circles. I'm going to go ahead and group them. So I'm going to Command G. I'm going to come back out, and to come in and out, you're going to hit Command minus or Command plus. Minus brings you out, plus brings you in. All right, so I'm going to come over here and get it around the top. A surefire way to line these up is to rubber band them together and then just hit this horizontal align. So what we want is we want to click on our speckle object, and then we're going to go over here to the rotate tool, which is R on our keyboard. We're going to find the center of this circle, and then we're going to hold Alt or Option, and we're going to go ahead and click it. So I'm going to use 10 degrees. Anytime you're going to be creating a shape along the path of a circle, you want to make sure it's divisible by 360, because if it's not, then you're going to not line up everything correctly, and then you're going to get a hot mess and you're going to wonder why. It's because of math. Yeah, that pesky thing, math. 10 obviously divides perfectly, so I'm going to go ahead and you just hold your click on the preview button, and we're going to copy. So it made a direct copy next to it, and it moved it 10 degrees. So to create the same command that we've done over and over again, all we have to do is hit Command or Control and D, and see, it does the exact same action that we did the last time. So you just keep hitting Command D all the way until we get all the way around the circle. All right, I'm going to go ahead and hit V. I'm going to click off on the circle, and then I'm just going to delete it because I don't need it. And then I'm going to go ahead and rubber band select all of these little speckles. I'm going to group them together, Command G. And then I'm going to expand, and I'm going to compound path them. And then we're going to do the exact same thing, placing the gold foil over here, pulling it out, sizing it down, bringing it back. And then we're going to go ahead and bring it to the back again. And then we're going to select these two, Command 7. And it's asking me, this document, it may fail because your mask is quite complicated. You just hit yes. All right. And then we have, there we go, gold speckles. So what we want to do is move these over here onto our circle. All right. And you can make them larger, make them smaller. I tend to like to sort of see how it kind of, I'm not holding shift and it kind of makes an oblong type shape. I kind of like this just so it gives a little bit more of an interesting kind of a look. And it's not super perfect. So, all right. There we have it. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to group them. I'm going to make it just a bit bigger. Move it down here. All right, so the font that we're working with for the feminine version is going to be Jenna Sue, which is a very ladylike name for this lady font. So I'm going to go ahead and hit here. I'm going to bring it up to about 48. I'm going to find Jenna Sue right here. And all of these... these are all commercial free ones that I downloaded from Font Squirrel. So there's quite a few over there, and this is not even like a quarter of them, I don't think. So, all right. And Jenny Marks. I am going to make you bigger though. Let's go 60. Let's go real big. There we go. Alrighty. And then this sans serif font that I have right here, it is called Caviar Dreams. Correct me if I'm wrong. I believe it was Robin Leach in The Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, who kind of, what was it? Champagne wishes and caviar dreams. I think that's what the saying was. All right, so we're going to go ahead and find caviar dreams. And I'm keeping my caps lock on. Photography. And there we have it. Just going to group it together so that we don't actually move everything out of place. And there you have it. The feminine lady font. You can make your, to thicken up your lines here, you can bump up the stroke, push it to 2, push it to 3, make them, you know, as thick or thin as you like. I kind of liked showing the little bit of it different on both of these. So we're just going to go ahead and move Miss Jenny out of the way. All right. So for the fellas up here, or at least, you know, the less ladylike logo out of the two here, I'm going to show you how to do a different way of creating something on a path here. So this is actually a brush stroke that we're going to be using. I'm going to go over here to the circles again. I need a stroke, but I don't want to fill. So, oh, need to uncheck that. Let's not do that. All right, so we're just going to switch it. And then hit L. And I'm going to go ahead and make my circle. All right, so the easiest way to get a brush stroke on your path is to actually go up here to your brushes panel. I mean, who knew, right? All right, so these grunge textures that I have here, I got over at creativemarket.com. There's tons and tons of amazing stuff over there, and they have freebies every week. So you can go over there and grab these. You can find any other kind of freebies that you think are going to work for your project. So that's how I got mine. How I loaded them into my brush panel here is I went to my little library icon, came down here to my vector packs, and then there is my grunge brushes pack. This is the one that I chose, and all you have to do is click it, and voila, there it is, on the path. This is also another way that you can get shapes on a path. So instead of doing this, you know, circular way that we had done with the little speckles here, you can create a brush, which, you know, you have a line of shapes that you want to have, all stars, all squares, triangles, mix them up, whatever. You would group them together in their straight path there, and then you just drag them into your brush panel. And then you did exactly what we did there. I just clicked on the brush, and then it filled it in on a path. The downside to doing it this way, and it's not seriously a downside, it's just, you know, what your preference is and what your project that you're working on is going to need, or what you want it to look like. The shape will take on a slight curve, so your shapes will be slightly out of I guess shape. So they'll just get a bit of a curve to them, which is perfectly fine, but it's just another way of doing it. So for this one, in order to get the texture on there and to make it kind of look like this one, what we're going to do is we need to expand the appearance, because right now it's only a path, and so we're going to go ahead and expand. We got all of this going on here, and then we're going to come over to your Pathfinder window if you don't see it, window, and then go to Pathfinder. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to merge, which is going to get rid of that outer ring up there, and then I'm going to hit exclude, which is going to get rid of these small little patches on the inside. Just because I kind of wanted it to be smoother. So what we're going to do, go object, compound path, then we're going to make, and then we're going to do exactly what we've done before. Grab the foil, come over here, place it, come out, make it small. And send it to the back. Rubber band them both together. Command 7. And yes. All right. And there you have it. So now the font that I used for James up here is called Pacifico, which is again a free font from Font Squirrel. So I'm gonna go ahead and come up here to Pacifico. There's also another really nice one that I like that was it's called Blackjack. It's quite popular actually. Also still looks, I mean, it's got a script look to it as well, but it's not as girly, I guess. All right, so gonna come in here and James Marks. They must be related or married, you know, keeping it in the family. All right, then we're gonna come over here and place it. And then I also use the same photography. I used Caviar Dreams because why not? Ooh. Don't want to change that one to Caviar Dreams. And then we're gonna go ahead and place it. Rubber band, group them together. Just close this out. I'm gonna move that out of the way. All right, there you have it. We completed two awesome logos. One for Jenny, one for James. I hope you guys like this tutorial. This tutorial is gonna be kind of like, I guess, to a two-parter tutorial. This week we did logos, and next week we are gonna, I mean, you know, the next tutorial is gonna be logos as well, but it's gonna be sort of more as a cohesive branding, you know, kind of a scheme that we're gonna be looking at. So we're going to, you know, create two other logos, one that's going to be sort of a smaller, you know, what you would put on your business card, and then an alternate logo as well. We're going to look at color schemes and picking out patterns and, you know, graphics and those kind of things and creating sort of a branding board. So next week is going to be more of branding. And I hope you guys are going to be looking forward to that one because I'm kind of really excited about that one. I've been, you know, working on branding my own website and everything. So there you have it. So we have everything here. We have the two logos. You guys are going to get some awesome free stuff. So don't forget to like, share, and comment on these videos. Let me know what you think. I would absolutely love to see what you guys come up with, using any of the techniques that we learned today. I always love hearing from you guys and seeing what you guys did. You guys are super creative and I absolutely love it. So, all right, until next time, go out there and create something amazing.